The Middle East is among the most water-stressed regions in the world. Freshwater supply here is naturally limited, and renewable resources are close to being exhausted.
We are talking about a very water-scarce region with low precipitation rates.
What is being predicted by climate change model is that less water will be available in the future.
The population is increasing, and we need to provide these people with the minimum requirement.
Due to this lack of water resources, or what I call the culture of scarcity, Israel needed to address to different kind of water resources and to be more effective.
Since the late 90s, Israel started to implement seawater desalination plans. Now, Israel is able to face even climate change impacts on water resources during the upcoming decades.
While Israel's fight against water scarcity is a success story, the situation in neighboring Palestine and Jordan is more pressing.
We are expecting now, during the next three decades, so up to 2050, a freshwater deficit for Jordan of about 700 million cubic meters. And in Palestine, we forecasted around 600 million cubic meters per year.
What we're trying to do in Salam is to cover this additional demand in water resources.
We are building a unique platform and achieved already in the project a great basis of trust. And this is really essential for transboundary water management in the region.
To avoid a serious water crisis in Palestine and Jordan, the Salam Initiative develops new concepts for producing and transporting fresh water to the demand centers.
Based on the fact that there are no new sources of water, any new source of fresh water will have to be desalinated water.
In the future, we have to find the cheapest way to desalinate in order to reduce the cost.
The key issue is the location, the geographical location of the desalination plant, and if it is onshore or offshore. If you include in the offshore solutions the cost of the land versus the cost of the installations offshore, there is no doubt that the trade-off is very good.
Desalinated water will be transferred by major conveyance pipelines between the seawater desalination plants and the demand areas. So new hydro infrastructure is being required to realize this transfer project.
We have defined a so-called macro model, which is basically outlining a network of possibilities of transporting water between the desalination plants and the demand areas, which are defined.
While supply of desalinated water is constant throughout the year, demand is highest in the hot and dry summer months. This requires solutions for water storage.
The main question is how you can take the water from the good years and to bring to the bad year.
One of the options that we are evaluating is to have a large desalination plant in the area north to Haifa and to transport the water to the Lake of Tiberias as a storage facility.
Lake Tiberias is at a level of minus 200 meters below the Mediterranean sea level, so you can use this kind of head drop in order to generate power. And what we're trying to do as far as the subsurface storage in aquifers is concerned, we're looking at different alternatives at different locations. Different types of aquifers. Some of them are more suitable than others.
We indicated potential areas for water storage. In Israel, it's mainly coastal aquifer and western mountain aquifer.
With our model of the western mountain aquifer, we found out that up to 1,300 million cubic meters of water may be stored, which could serve as a strategic reserve in times of drought.
The additional fresh water creates plenty of wastewater that, when treated, could be used to irrigate crops, recharge depleted aquifers, and rehabilitate the Jordan River.
An addition of 1 billion cubic meters of fresh water to the area will generate substantial amounts of effluent. We can say between 60 to 80%, depending on the efficiency of the treatment. All over the world, people would like to see a Jordan Valley with the Jordan River flowing, This is not wasting water, this is investing in rehabilitating a valley and the river that could pay off in terms of tourism and visiting and recreation and quality of life.
To implement developed alternatives, SALAM created a series of user-friendly applications to help authorities manage water resources effectively and efficiently.
There are several tools which have been developed. For example, the water budget tool, which allows to study the impact of different assumptions with regards to development and climate change scenarios on the projected freshwater deficits in the region. We developed a multi-criteria analysis tool, which enables exactly the evaluation, comparison, and ranking of decision alternatives. I hope that based on this platform, the decision makers of the region will be able to do an important step forward towards a commonly agreed water development strategies.
It's very important to work together to provide safe water supply.
The SALAM project can show the decision maker the benefit of cooperation and also provide them some technical visible solution.
The fact that we are working together and looking at the same data together creates a common language.
We don't invent all these concepts, but we bring it together and apply it to the region, to its unique topography, to its unique population, and to its unique setting at large.
SALAM has found a quantitative solution to the water deficit problem in Palestine and Jordan. It is now up to future collaborators to put these strategies into practice and provide water where it is needed, when it is needed.